Yeah, the ceramic coating is going to bring up another level of gloss to them.
Well, Dick, here's the deal. I'm the best there is, plain and simple. Well, I mean, I wake up in the morning, I piss excellence.
Thank you.
And nobody can hang with my stuff. Just a big, hairy American winning machine. If you ain't first, you're last.
Hello, I'm Jensen. What's going on, everybody? Hope you're having a great day. If you're new to the channel, make sure you like and subscribe. So I hope that you guys saw the last video of me unrevealing the brand new wheels. Right now, I'm about to hop in the Drift Cat, go get gas, and then take the new wheels over to SR Garages so he can get them ceramic coated. And I'm going to show you guys the process on one wheel because I've never seen it done in person before. So that'll be pretty cool to see. But yeah, let's hop in, go get gas, and then head over there. But first, you know what we gotta do? Quick cold start. And as you guys can see, got them all loaded up. One in the passenger seat, two in the rear, and then one in the trunk. So if you guys ever wondered if you could fit four rims in a Hellcat Charger, now you know. Hopefully it's in order. Looks like it's in order. Last time it was out of order, so I had to go to the one where it's like $5. Thank God. $349. Not bad. Not bad. This is definitely the slowest pump I've ever been to. Been so long. I don't know how long I've been here, but it's only at just gonna hit 10 gallons, $35. So let's see what time it is by the time I leave here, because this shit is taking forever. So it's 104. This shit is finally done. $46. Ran into bro at the gas station.
You know what I'm saying? Make sure y'all fuck with my guy Jensen.
Nice meeting you, bro.
Yeah.
Have a good one. He wants to hear it.
Oh, you started it.
SR Garages now. Thank you to SR Garage for emptying his garage for me. That was a lot of garages, but yeah, he emptied his garage so we can take a little video of ceramic coating these, and then gonna put them up next to the car to see how they look. Yes sir,
always doing something.
So yeah, let's take these things out. I was surprised I fit all of them in here, to be honest.
I was actually wondering, how's he gonna get them here?
Yeah, those are...
Is this one open now, right?
Yeah, those are open. Nah, these ones are closed. These ones are closed. Yeah, these ones are open. We're going to go ahead and take all these out and get his reaction, because these are a lot better than those wheels. Got them unloaded. Take a look. They still got the cover on them because I really like this little,
like the little
dust cover.
Sheesh, look at those things.
Way better, huh?
Maybe, yeah. Lightweight series.
Yeah, so these are 24 pounds, and supposedly the stock ones, these are replica wheels that are on, but the like the Brass Monkey ones, mm-hmm. Those are like 30 pounds, so save 6 pounds each wheel.
So let's take a look. Actually, Belgian.
Yeah, they make a lot of different wheels.
They would look nice on the Durango.
Yeah, these are VF9s. They have a few different variations. But yeah, I really like this spoke pattern. Someone said they look like BMW wheels, and I see it. Kind of see it, but...
Yeah, they kind of do. They got a little bit of resemblance, like the M wheels.
Yeah, but I really like them. Yeah, last time you had the Rotiform wheels, they were a little spotty. These look very nice, though. Could you even see any imperfections?
Here, give me a second.
I mean, because we do want our honest opinion, you know. We don't want to be favoritism, even though these are sponsored wheels. And big shout out to Velgen. Thank you very much once again. And I don't know if it's Velgen or Velgen, because it's not a J, it's a G. But I'm not sure.
So, you want my real honest opinion?
Yeah, for sure.
They actually look very, very decent.
Yeah, because I was going to say there's no dirt or anything in them.
No, I don't see any dirt. I don't see maybe one little blemish right there with a little dirt, but minimal.
Yeah.
Compared to the other wheels that we won't name, but yeah, no, these are good. Yeah, they're nice.
Beautiful. And I'm sure these are powder coated.
Yeah.
Yeah. Are these the... Okay, so these are the by 11. So these are the rear wheels.
Yeah. No, this is the 9.
Is it? Nine. Oh, you just put this box on top? Okay, okay, okay.
Yeah, I wanted to build me a little
table.
Little table.
So yeah, these look really good. You want to pull out the bottoms to compare?
They got real nice concave to them too.
Yeah, these ones are even more concave. I'm hella excited to see what they're gonna look like on the car.
It's gonna look pretty sick.
Yeah, these ones have a really nice concave to them. These are the by 11s. Pretty wide.
Yep.
Pretty wide. See anything?
No, these are good too. These are really good.
Beautiful.
Quality's really good. In black, you notice everything, so you see it right away.
And what were the other wheels? I think they were silver?
Silver.
So those hide a lot, and you could still tell.
Yep.
They had a lot of dirt and things wrong with them.
Nah, these are good. These are really good.
Yeah, so...
One small little blemish there.
Oh, yeah, that's tiny, though.
But that's it. Again, compared to
the
last set of wheels.
Awesome. Shout out to Velgen, however you pronounce it. Thank you guys very much. Yeah, as you guys can see how deep the concave is. These are the front ones, a little less concave, but still pretty deep. Very nice. You wanna throw them next to the car to see how they look?
Yeah.
Need to throw like a little towel down or something so they don't stretch.
Oh, like right next to them?
Yeah. So we can get like the side view, you know? It's really good about the lightweight ass wheels.
Oh yeah, it's gonna look pretty sick.
Yeah, it is.
This is gonna look nice.
So if you guys can imagine, yeah, those are gonna look really good. I'm not even gonna put them on until I get the new wrap. Mm-hmm. I haven't told you what the new wrap is. I haven't told anyone what the new wrap is, to be honest. I was looking at that blue. I don't think I'm gonna do the blue. I'm gonna do something else. But yeah. These wheels, I ordered black lug nuts too,
mm-hmm.
just because
yep.
these things poke out. And then I'm either going to do, I was talking to Josh, he said either do the Mickey Thompsons if I really want to hook. Our Triple 8s are good for a street tire, or he said the Nitto NT Triple 5s. So one of the three, I don't know what I'm going to do. I got to... Yeah, get some opinions from people.
Yeah, the Nittos, that's what I hear everybody run.
I've seen a lot of people run those. Yeah. But I don't know if they have this much power. You know?
Yeah, true.
That might be a deciding factor. So, and I do see a lot of supercars like twin turbo Lamborghinis and shit that have the R888s. So I don't know. I know that's more of a track tire, but these aren't going to be my drag setup. Mostly just my street setup with the sticky tire on it so I can get some traction. Rather than having street tires on them. We're gonna go ahead and ceramic coat one of these. You wanna do the rears or the front one?
Oh, it don't matter.
Yeah, it's kind of the same size surface. Okay, all new towels and everything.
Yeah.
This is a way better angle so you guys can see how much wider the rears are versus the fronts. Not extreme amount, but an inch and a half. All right, flip them over because he said he likes to do the barrels first, which makes sense.
So these barrels have light texture to them. The faces are literally glossy.
Yeah, like super, paint. Super glossy.
So we're gonna use some of this.
Okay.
My go-to. Got my applicator and my rags. Yeah, see, actually, when you can feel it right here, this is right at the very edge on the lip, is where the texture changes.
Oh, yeah,
it does. Feel it really smooth and feel a little bit of roughness.
Huh.
I always like to time it.
Because you have to wipe it in a certain amount of time?
Yeah, you got to wipe it in a certain time. You don't want to let it sit on there forever, and then you want to let it sit there for a certain amount of time. Give this a quick little wipe. Get all of our oily substances removed.
Some secret sauce, a little decontaminant.
Yep. That's it.
Really? Wow. You can see how much glossier it is.
So it'll stay right there like that, kind of glossy looking because it's setting in, but it's not gonna stay super glossy like that.
But yeah, you can definitely tell there's like a little extra sealant on it now.
Gonna be really hard to capture in the video as it's setting, but it'll turn rainbowish.
Yeah, they're definitely have a little bit more like sheen, shine to
very
them.
Very lightly, yeah.
And then now it's protected from axle grease, dirt, rocks, rubber.
Yeah.
All that shit. That's one thing that I've never done is ceramic coat the wheels. Well, we did the pair.
Brass monkey ones.
Two of them, right? Uh-huh. Two brass monkeys. And I think those are the cleanest wheels that I have like all the time. So definitely excited to get these ceramic coated.
You can lightly see it.
Yeah, hopefully you guys can see it through the camera. I can definitely see it in person. But there's a
gives
small,
it a very, very light.
Yeah, like a hue of rainbow.
Yeah. And then some of this too, what you see, and again, you may not be able to see it in camera, but I see it in person, is when the clear coat gets applied, you get a little bit of mist into the barrel.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So you've got a little bit of like, you know, clear coat from what's on the outside in here, just a very little bit. That's why if you look at it, it looks kind of, you know, kind of flat on one portion and then super, super shiny on the other.
Okay, yeah,
you know
that's
what I mean?
True.
Because of the clear coat just overspread inside.
But that doesn't matter because that's the back of the room. Now, I'm pretty sure you're definitely going to be able to see the more rainbow effect on these.
You might be able to see it.
Because even though it's still black, it's going to be a little bit better to capture.
Clean off all of our fingerprints. Now doing wheels, it takes time. You got to be a little more thorough than anything because all the crevices, all the cracks.
Yeah, way more intricate than just like a flat panel.
Definitely.
Hella curves and edges.
Mm-hmm. Now, I already have some, so I'm just applying a little bit more. That's it, really. See that right there?
Yeah, I don't know if the camera's a little bit.
Right here.
Getting a little rainbowy. And then use this one to kind of spread it around.
Yeah, use this one to level it out. Make sure it's pretty much everywhere.
And then wipe it off.
And then I use the other one to wipe it.
Okay.
After it's set for a certain amount of time. That's why every time I ceramic coat anything, I have my timer going.
Literally have like, to sit there
I
and wait.
I can't do anything. I just gotta watch it. Now doing a car, of course, is a whole different thing because I gotta do paint correction. I gotta prep it.
Very
There's
true.
A lot more
steps. You can already see how much shinier these are.
The ceramic coating is gonna bring up another level of gloss to them.
Yeah, most definitely. And you said you're gonna do three coats per wheel?
Yeah, I'm gonna do two on the outside and three on the inside.
Okay. Wow. So is it gonna get shinier and shinier?
It'll probably get a little bit shinier, yeah.
Yeah? Wow.
Now the only problem with that, you know, it doesn't matter how many cuts you do, it's just gonna take forever.
Yeah.
Because you have to, I have to wait a certain amount of time before I can do the next coat. Like this will be done and then it just sits.
Because it has to harden and.
Yep.
Okay.
I have to wait at least an hour. So that's why when I ceramic coat cars, same thing. When I'm doing multiple layers, it's gotta sit for an hour. Oh yeah, you can see right away.
That's beautiful. All right, let's do a quick comparison of the two. This is the ceramic coated one, and this is the uncoated one. These are so much more shiny. I'm not sure if you guys would be able to tell on camera.
Yeah, the glossiness magnifies after you coat them.
Yeah, for sure. He's gonna do the rest of them. Three more to go. A lot of coats to go because he's gonna do
multiple layers.
Yeah, two on the outside and then three on the inside barrel. So we're gonna leave these with him, pick them up in a few days or whatever. No rush, because I told him I'm not gonna throw the wheels on until I get the wrap. I'm looking at trying to track down the wrap right now. Of course, it's back ordered and sold out everywhere. My wrap guy told me that there's one roll in Detroit, so hopefully we can get that so we can get the car wrapped, throw these wheels on, and then
have hopefully before 2022.
Yeah, hopefully
come out super heavy for 2022.
Yeah, nice little makeover for the Drift Cat. I know you guys have been asking for it. It's coming. Be patient. Once again, thank you to Velgen or Velgen Wheels. I'm still not positive. But yeah, thank you guys. I appreciate you sending me out the wheels. Big thank you to SR Garage for ceramic coating them, making them look 10 times as good. We'll pick these things up in a couple days, leave them here, and might need to get a wash when we pick them up. Not gonna lie, this thing's a little dirty. That's pretty much gonna be the end of this video. Thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it. Make sure you like, subscribe, comment, share, hit the bell, thumbs up, all that stuff. Make sure you guys go follow SR Garage on Instagram. Come get your wheels ceramic coated, your car ceramic coated, detailed, all types of stuff. Right now he's doing a little carpet clean, shampoo and extraction on the Infiniti right there. So he does all type of vehicles. Make sure you hit him up. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you in the next one. Deuces.